Hi. I'm looking for a white lady that's tattooed and dominant and be willing to put me in a dress and beat the shit out of me. Call me.
On this episode of The Commercial Break.
He's like average guy, but like he takes good care of himself. First time he got raped.
Wait, hold on. Was she just saying that he's an average guy?
Yeah, she's talking about one of their clients.
Oh, he was an average guy.
Yeah, but he also is, he's below average. If you had to rate his looks on a 1 to 10, I mean, I don't want to like, you know, I don't want to become that show, but I'm just asking you personally for your own personal opinion.
It's a pain level of 5.
The next episode of The Commercial Break starts now.
Oh, yeah, cats and kittens, welcome back to The Commercial Break. I'm Bryan Green. This is my dear friend and co-host, the extremely talented and intelligent Kristen Joy Hoadley. Best to you, Krissy.
Best to you, Bryan.
And best to you out there in the podcast universe. Krissy.
Bryan.
You're probably not going to answer this, but I'm going to ask the question anyway. Krissy's a little bit more reserved than I am. She actually thinks she has a future after the commercial break. I, on the other hand, know it's the end of the line for me.
Oh, no, we're in it together.
Oh, yeah?
We're Thelma and Louise going off the cliff.
Yeah, we're going to be here at the end of days, still doing this stupid podcast.
We'll just get your, you know, because you want to do the basement thing.
Yeah, I do.
With the doomsday.
Yeah, even though I don't have a basement. I want, what I'd like to
You're
do.
You're going to dig a basement.
I'm going to dig a basement for my children. I'm going to put them down there probably another year or so.
We're going to drain the pool.
Drain the pool. Cover it up. Exactly. Cement on top. And just tell the kids, I'm just going to give them everything they want. TV, Nintendo Switch, whatever they want. I'm just going to give canned junk food all the time. I'm just going to send them down there with a bunch of shit. And I'm going to have like a microphone. They can listen to the commercial break for updates. And I'm going to be like, listen, if by 2050 you don't hear from me personally, I don't open the top of the pool, check to make sure there's still green outside and oxygen. And then you come out and yep. make your way in the world. And then you're old enough to date and get married on your own.
Yep.
Do you pee-pee in the shower? Pee-pee in the shower?
I mean, doesn't everybody sometimes?
No,
sometimes?
Not everybody does. I didn't very frequently pee in the shower until I met Astrid.
Yeah.
And she was like, let it fly, kid.
Yeah.
Like, let it fly. What
do
does it matter?
Do double duty.
Yeah, and then I started thinking to myself,
brush your teeth in there, too.
Yeah, I do brush my teeth in there.
Because,
mm-hmm. yeah, I do double duty. You know, right. Why waste the time to yeah. get out of the shower than brush my teeth? It's just easier. I feel like I go for a top-down approach.
Yeah.
I go hair first, then teeth, then body, then butt,
then
feet.
Yeah, I think that's my routine as well.
Because that's how your mom or dad taught you how to wash yes. things, right? It's like when you wash the window, you don't go from the bottom up. You go from the top down.
Correct.
That way you're not, you know, messing up what you just cleaned up. Anyway, the point is, not everybody pees in the shower. Recent study shows that only 1 in 3 people pee in the shower. Hmm. That seems like a low number to me. I would have thought it'd been more like at least 1 in 2.
I mean, these are people that are admitting it,
yeah, of
I
course.
Guess.
Yeah. But I mean, you know, what's so embarrassing about peeing in the shower? It's just pee-pee. Some people drink it. There's a lot of people now that are drinking their pee. What's that fucking wrong? What's funk? What's wrong with people, by the way?
Are they lost in the desert?
No, they're just drinking their pee because they think it there's all these quacking bushes.
Oh, that's waste. It's waste.
Yeah.
It's your body's waste.
It is. It's vinegar with bacteria
in it. Unless you're stuck in the desert on a desert island.
Even then, I think I'm just dying. Yeah. I think I'm just dying. Floating on a raft out in the sea. You know, I go on those cruises. I've been on a couple cruises. And every time, like, there's a moment of terror, usually at night when I'm on the balcony alone by myself. There's a moment
with
of terror.
With 10 cameras.
Yeah, with 10 cameras. That's right. With the Disney cruise ship closely monitoring me. Yeah.
There he is.
Look out for him. He's taking pictures of the kids. Is he pissing off the balcony? There's always a moment of terror where I think about what would happen if, like, you know, I was to fall overboard or the ship went down and I was stuck on a raft. Would I eat? Would I drink my own pee? Probably not. Probably not. No, I drink the salt water and die that way.
Dehydrate yourself.
I'd catch a shark by my teeth, rip open its liver and drink the blood. But there's a lot of these guys out there now that are saying, like, drink your pee every once in a while to help keep, I don't know, your hormone levels up or something. People are fucking quacking bushes right now. They're all quacking bushes.
Trying anything.
They're trying anything. So I'm reading this study. about showering habits, and there's like a lot of different stuff. Do people brush their teeth in
and
the shower?
And there's some people that don't wash. We talked about washing legs.
I only do the washing of the legs on the second shower, not the first shower of the day, because I figure I just wash my legs, so I really need to wash them again. However, my butt gets washed every time. Just sharing that with everyone.
I feel like my thighs get washed more than my shin.
My
shin doesn't seem dirty.
Yeah, I don't know. Who gets their shin dirty?
I'll do the feet.
Yeah.
But, you know, the soap from the thigh runs down the shin.
Yeah.
And then you go straight to the foot.
Right.
Yeah.
It's all running down there. It's already cleaning it up. And it's not like I have sweat glands on my calf muscles. It's not like I walk into a meeting and I'm like, oh, sorry, I got sweaty calves. Did you see his sweaty calves? He should have used Secret.
Right.
So
unless you've been on one of those mud runs,
there's special circumstances where the calves get washed. But on a normal day, I'm just breezing over that part of the body.
When I get a pedicure, the calves get washed.
Yeah, once every 6 months, I get my calves washed by the pedicure lady. Oh man, I love a pedicure.
Oh,
by the way,
so
I don't
good.
Give a shit what anybody says. I love
Jeff's
a pedicure.
Into him too.
Oh
he
man, it's
it.
The best, and it's not about the pedicure because it's nice. But I do like to have my toenails
toes,
very
yeah.
short. The other, you know what I was watching? It was Love Is Blind, and one of the guys had long fingernails, long rounded fingernails. Ooh. And I thought to myself, that's such a bad look, guys. I mean, I understand there could be like a fashion statement. You like to paint your fingers. You know, it's part of like what your identification. I get that. But on a normal day,
no.
Guys with long fingernails gross me out unless you're the cocaine dealer. And then I'm really excited. Actually, that's how I identify the cocaine dealer. The guy with the one
pinky.
Oh, man. I used to have a dealer and he had this long pinky and he just, it was highly disgusting, but yeah. He was just passing it around to everybody, and I thought to myself, okay. Sure, why not? I don't know what's in the cocaine either, so it doesn't matter. What was disturbing about these thousand or so people that were asked about their showering habits, and they were mainly younger, like Gen Z millennials and then Gen Xers, our age, was, have you ever pooped in the shower? And 12.7% of the people said they have pooped in the shower on a somewhat regular basis or
no.
a regular basis. Who are you?
No.
Identify yourself.
Yes.
So we can also put you in the pool.
Yes.
You're going into the pool, but not with my children.
Pool storage.
Yeah, the community pool. The one that's already got poo-poo in it. You know what I'm saying?
That's
okay.
True.
Because that is fucking disgusting.
No, yeah, you can't poop in the pool.
You don't.
Come on.
If I had a choice,
poop in the shower.
I wouldn't poop at all. But if I'm going to poop, I poop under duress and I do it in my own bathroom and in my own toilet. And we have a water closet.
What about the squatty potty, too? Like, what, are they taking the squatty potty into the shower?
Yeah, what do you do?
I don't know.
Like, do you have a bench in the shower?
Like, there's a drain.
Yeah.
Like, what?
I guess you smush it with your
foot.
Oh,
don't say it.
In this case.
Oh.
And in this case only, that 12.7% that's pooping in the shower, I really do hope you're washing your calves. Because
yes.
In that case, the shit is rolling downhill.
That's true.
Is that not horrifying information?
It is horrifying.
Is that not horrifying information? Who
yes.
in the fuck are you people? Please identify yourself so the rest of us can stay away from you. And if you're brave enough to text me and let me know why exactly you poop, defend yourself. You don't even give your name. Just defend your pooping in the shower habits. I'd like to know that. Or send us, hit the contact us button, give a fake email, and tell us why you think it's okay to poop in the shower. I would love to understand some of the TikTok behind this, because I have never once, not ever thought about pooping in the shower.
No.
I would never do that.
No,
it's highly disgusting. You don't know the lengths I go to make sure that I don't even poop outside of my own home.
I mean, even if you have some kind of an emergency in
yes.
there, like a bad stomach ache, the toilet's right there. Jump out and get to the toilet.
Yeah, I very rarely go into a shower that's not attached to a toilet. You know what I'm saying? Like, which shower are you using that doesn't have a toilet right nearby? The campsite? Maybe? Jail? I guess? I don't know. I mean, seriously, guys, we got to get it together. This is also proof.
It's a quick hop out to the toilet, then back in to wash
yes.
yourself.
Yeah, because I can't poop wet.
Then you're...
yeah, I can't poop wet under any circumstances. If I have to poop in the shower, if there's ever been like a poop urgency that I have in the middle of a shower, I have to dry myself all the way off, Then I poop. Then I get back in the shower and I will wash whatever part of my body I've washed, I'll wash again. If I've brushed my teeth, I'll brush them again. Because I have to be that kind of clean when I get out of the shower. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
But pooping wet is a no-no. So sometimes, like, the kids, they're like, they'll be in the bathtub and they'll be like, my tummy hurts. And then I'm like, okay, let's dry you off. And then sometimes my kids are like, no.
I gotta go right now.
Yeah, and you have to put them, and I always think to myself, like, it's really uncomfortable to be wet, cold, and pooping.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, it's gross.
And you kind of slide around on the seat.
Then you can't be assured it's actually getting in the toilet.
Oh, my God.
Oh. Only once.
We've officially become, we are epitomizing toilet humor
yes.
right now.
Wait, guys. The commercial break has reached a new high of lows. We are at the high of lows, just to let you know. There's only one circumstance that I have ever been in where it was like a true poop urgency and I wasn't near a toilet. And that's when I was stuck in traffic one time here in Atlanta.
Oh, God, that's the worst.
And I had a bubbly gut.
And
it was so painful. I was and I just made it into the driveway and just happened to jump out of the car.
Yeah.
And it went. But luckily I was at my own house.
Right.
And no one was home at the time.
You throw away your clothes.
Well, I went in the backyard. We had this towel that we used to like clean the dog off with.
Blue.
Yeah.
What did you do? What are you doing?
No, this is years ago. This is a different dog altogether. But this nasty towel that had been sitting out, getting wet, drying off, getting wet. So it was like basically hard as a rock. You could like hit it on something. And what I did was I took all my clothes off and I just like kind of wrapped the towel around me. I threw the clothes away. It's not even worth it. I don't even want
to
wash it.
Throw the clothes away.
Yeah. Now that I have kids, it's a whole different animal.
Right.
Poop is the least of my concerns. Oh, I want to tell you this. So, short story, and then we'll get back to John Anthony. I know everyone's interested in getting to John Anthony's blueprint. We'll get there. I took my mom to the emergency room over the weekend.
God, because I'm sorry to hear that.
She broke her ankle in multiple places, foot and toe. Poor lady. You know, she called me, and you know, like me, I learned it from my mom. We're both prone to histrionics, right? And so sometimes we can be a little over-dramatic about things. And so when my mom first called on Saturday, said she fell in the shower, she had to get the fire department to come over to get her out and all this other stuff. I was like, oh my gosh, but this isn't the first time this has happened. That's why she's at one of these places. She has a little pull cord, right? And her mobility's not so good. So after a couple of hours of her calling me and saying, well, I need some, you know, should I just take some Advil? My foot is swelling up. You know, maybe I'll just put some ice on it. I finally was like, no, we need to go to the emergency room. Mm-hmm. It was Saturday. So I was like, we need to go to the emergency room. There is no place on earth like a busy emergency room on a Saturday night.
No
place on earth.
Our emergency rooms in general are just awful to go to.
But like,
I hate them.
But I've been to so many times for so many different reasons. And a lot of times the emergency room is like, it's not busy. So there's only one or two or five, you know, five other people there. This was full house the entire time. People just kept coming in with different injuries. There was one guy who had a broken arm and you could see the bone poking his skin. And he was a guy my age and he was fucking bawling. And I know because I've broken my arm. It hurts. There was just a lot of different things. I won't get into all the more morbid stuff. But what did happen was we were sitting in a row of chairs. And then there was a couple seats in front of us that were empty. And a dad, a very scattered father, walks in with his son. You can tell this is not
usually. Who isn't scattered when you're in the emergency room?
True story. But this father was extra scattered, right? He was just like, where do I go? What do I do? You need my insurance card? Sit down, stand up, do this, do that. You know, you could tell this was not his normal role. Mom usually took care of this stuff. He was filling it.
Oh, okay.
My assumption, right? Because if this kid's father is like this 24 hours a day, this kid's fucked. But anyway, he was trying to be a good father, right? He was just very scattered. You could tell he was nervous about whatever was going on. So they sat down right in front of us, and the kid had a blanket over him, like a binky, like a blankie. He was probably 5 or 6 years old, not much older than my own kids. And his dad kept rubbing his back. He kept asking the question, and this is so funny how he said this. He kept asking the question, how's your pain level? Are we at a 3? Are we at a 4? What are we at? 1 to 10. Tell me, what are we at? You know, and the kid would be like, for a long time, he was like, 4, daddy. And he's like, 4, 4. That's good. Good boy. Good baby. Good job, baby. Good job. Go, baby. Like he was cheering him on for a baseball game or something. But then eventually the pain level got to like a 6, right?
Well, do the kids at that age even really realize what that means?
No, of course they don't. They have no fucking clue. They're just looking at their dad.
Yeah.
Right. They're looking at their dad. Whatever their dad says, you know, is it a 4 or 5? You know, 4.
Right.
Probably at a 10. I don't know. Who knows? So then eventually, after an hour, the kid had just been kind of slumped over on his father's, leaning toward his father. His head fell forward, and his dad jumped up. Whoa. He's screaming, whoa. And I'm like, oh my God, what happened there? Right.
Yeah.
And my mom's like, Bryan. And I don't know, Mom, you know? And I can hear liquid splattering everywhere. So within 3 seconds, I realize I think he's either throwing up or he's bleeding out of the nose, one of the two.
Yeah.
His father runs away. He ran 100 feet to go to the front desk where no one is medically responsible for you. It's just a lady there taking your name. He ran to the front desk and his kid is sitting there hunched over, throwing up.
Ooh.
But when you have children or when you've seen a child puke, or maybe even yourself, you know that it's really easy to get into a state of hyperventilation. And the concern is, do you suck back that stuff into your lungs, right? That's aspiration. And it happens. That's why they say when people are drunk and they pass out, turn them over on their side so that the puke doesn't go back in their throat. So this poor kid is like, puke everywhere, projectile vomiting, right?
Oh, God.
And I stand up, I grab the kid, I kind of put him on my knee, and I'm rubbing his back and like patting his back and his head. And I'm like, it's okay, just get it out. You're doing great. You know, go, right? You know, get it out.
Where's the dad?
He's up at the front desk. I don't know, making arrangements for dinner and making a reservation at the table. I don't even know what the fuck is going on. But I'm thinking to myself, where is your father? Like, so his father comes running back and he's got like a little tiny bag in him. He's like, and now he's all done throwing up. So I'm like, well, there we go. So I put the kid back in the chair. His dad is avoiding the throw up that's everywhere like the plague. He's like dancing around the kid. He's not even touching him because he's afraid to step in the puke.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, I've got puke all over me because I've now grabbed this kid.
Jumped into action.
I did. So I ran to the bathroom. I grab a bunch of towels. There's like a janitor there. And I'm like, hey, do you have any towels? Yeah, towels. So I go over there and I start cleaning the kid up, right? And he's like, here, give me some of those. And so I give him them. And now he's cleaning up the puke off of the bottom of his shoes.
Oh.
And I'm like, dude, what are you doing? Your kid is sitting here throwing up, projectile vomiting. By the way, I have no idea what this kid has.
Well, I was going to say, what was actually wrong with the
kid? I don't know. He could have the Four Seasons monkey disease. I don't know what the fucking kid has.
Yeah.
But I don't care because I see my own child in this child.
Sure.
And I don't want anything bad to happen to him. My fatherly instincts just kicked. What have I become? I don't know.
That's sweet, Bryan.
Anyway, it's not about me. It's about the kid. So yeah. The father says, after everything calmed down and the janitor came over to clean up, the father just kind of turned back and he was like, hey, thanks, man. And I was like, yeah, I get it. You know, I got some of my own. And I was like, I hope he feels better. And he goes, we're pretty sure it's appendicitis.
Mm.
So, okay, great. My mom gets seen. We're there for 30,000 hours.
Oh, yeah.
The next morning, my mom needs to get her medication. So I go to the local grocery store, to the pharmacy, to pick up the medication. I'm then get some other stuff, and I'm checking out at the self-checkout line. And somebody, I can feel something tug at my...
No way.
It's the same kid in the same fucking clothes with his mother. And he's like, he just says, thank you. That's what he says. And the mom then comes over and she goes, oh, he mentioned you saw him last night at the emergency room. And I was like, it took me a second to kind of register.
Yeah, because you weren't expecting it.
Yeah. But since he was in the same clothes, I recognized what
was. Why was he in the same clothes?
Don't
the
ask
puke
me.
Clothes?
They had just gotten out of the hospital. They had just gotten out of the hospital.
He'd been there all night. Oh.
And so she says, oh, I heard, you know, my son told me and my husband told me that someone had helped when he started throwing up, and thank you very much.
Daddy ran away, this man helped.
That's right. I wanted to say your husband fucking ran like a chicken shit away. You got to whip this guy into shape. What are you doing? Divorce him. Divorce is better than whatever's going on at that house, I can guarantee you. So it was the craziest. So anyway, she tells me, he does have appendicitis. They gave him some medication. They're going to let the appendix calm down. He's going to go in for surgery on Monday to get the appendix taken out. And I was like, oh, that's good. You know, don't worry about it. It's good. I'm sure they'll give you candy or something. You know, you get ice cream afterwards or whatever. And he's like, yeah, but, and then he gives me a hug on my leg. And I was like, oh man, fucking heartbreaker. Who are these people that don't have licenses to have children that are running around having children? I mean, listen, I can't say that I would do anything in a particular circumstance, because maybe I would have reacted the exact same way had it been my son throwing up. Because I do avoid the puke like the plague.
You do.
But when it comes to the children, I get my hands dirty because it's an emergency at that point. You can't not get your hands dirty.
They need help.
So, but I just, beyond all of the craziness and the poor kid who had appendicitis and the throwing up and the father, what was the most insane is that not 12 hours after I left that hospital, I saw the same kid. I literally was freaking out when I left the grocery store. I was like, how fucking fucked up is that? How crazy is it? And it, granted, it's within a 5-mile radius, both of these things, right? Mm-hmm. It makes sense that the hospital is close to the grocery store and that they could have at any point in time been there. Mm-hmm. But to be there at the same time that I'm there to pick up my mother's medication, a grocery store I almost never go to because it's not next door to my house, was insane. It was insane. And it just goes to show the power of the commercial break, bringing people together. No, it's not the commercial break. So then I gave the kid a 21 EPM sticker and I said, hey, when you're recovering, because your dad's not going to be with you, when you're recovering, pop on your iPhone, which I'm sure you have at 5, pop on your iPhone and throw on the commercial break. We could use the download. It'll give you That's a good right. giggle. Yeah.
I was going to say, did you say to the dad that night at the hospital, like, hey, do you have Patreon?
Yeah. Hey, you want to open up your Spotify real quick? Let me follow.
I went out of town this past weekend, and I can't tell you how many people wanted to know about the commercial break. And I, you know, go into their phone, I hit follow, and so I think we've got some new subscribers down in Mississippi. Great.
That is fantastic. Yeah. Love those Mississippi people. Mm-hmm. MISSISSIPPI. Mm-hmm. I remembered how to spell it. TCB. Hey you, guess you. I hate to interrupt all the fun, but I just want to remind you that tcbpodcast.com is where you find all the audio and the video, plus you can contact us to get your free 21 EPM sticker. Just go to tcbpodcast.com, hit the contact us button, tell us you want a sticker, drop us your address, and off we go. Plus, you can write to us at 855-TCB-8383. That's 1-855-TCB-8383. For all of our international listeners, we'll pick up the toll. Go ahead and text us. If you have comments, questions, concerns, content ideas, we're taking them all at 855-TCB-8383. If you want to view the commercial break in a whole new light, go to youtube.com/thecommercialbreak to see the fully edited episodes. You'll love it or your money back, I promise. While you're at it, hit us up on Instagram at The Commercial Break and TCB Live on TikTok. So let's take a minute to hear from our sponsors and then we'll be back to this episode of The Commercial Break.
How's your money feeling? It's about to feel happier with a certificate from Happy Money's partner, Michigan State University Federal Credit Union. Elevate and increase your savings with 18-month terms and only a $500 minimum. And the happiest part? MSU FCU certificates yield 4.5% APY annual percentage yield. Now that's a happier side of money. Elevate your savings. Go to happymoney.com/MSUFCU. That's MSUFCU. Funds insured up to $250,000 by NCUA. The APY is accurate as of the 12/1/2023 dividend declaration date. Early withdrawal penalties do apply. Fees may reduce earnings on the account. Any monthly withdrawals or transfers reduce earnings. TCB.
All right, I was trolling on the internet.
As you do.
Besides my serendipitous, you know, we'll get over my serendipity. I just thought I'd share that interesting story. And don't poop in the shower. Please, don't do it.
Just don't do it.
I was trolling on the internet.
As you do.
As I do. Last episode, we're listening to John Anthony and Brazil.
International dating coach.
International dating coach extraordinaire. Yeah, with over 1,800 confirmed polls. Mm-hmm. And threesomes, they stopped counting. So we don't know how many threesomes they had.
Yeah, you know, they stopped counting last year.
Yeah, last year. Because, you know, threesomes happen all the time. Especially when you're paying both the women to have the threesome.
Exactly. Yeah. And especially when you're a DJ at a house party late night.
Go back, listen to the episode. It's crazy the way these people are talking. But they had just started getting into some of their secret blueprint to threesomes. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to make sure that we finished this video because I know
Can we just go over them real quick? So far, there are none.
There are none. Yeah, let's go over.
One was that you make sure and separate the girl from the herd and ditch the friend. Don't invite the friend.
That's right. Hold on. Give me 1 second and I'll play a little, couple, like a little truncated clip of John Anthony. So far, the pointers that we've gotten on this John Anthony video about how to pull threesomes.
We don't know.
That's right, guys. You're not going to be pulling threesomes like this because you can't afford to have women of the night around you all day long. But John Anthony, he's a different case. He can. So I was trolling on the internet.
As you do.
Did I already say that?
Yes.
Okay.
But I, as you do.
As I like to do. As I do. As I do.
Not in the shower.
Not in the shower. Never in the shower, guys. Okay, here we go.
Okay,
accomplish those goals usually as quick as 1 to 2.
Yeah, he's giving us a link to his free
30-minute call link in the description.
It used
below.
To be a 90-minute call. I guess he's. Yeah. I guess he's got more clients now. Yeah.
Months. Okay, so check out that free 30-minute call link in the description. So, do you have any comments regarding like the photo selection process, picking the high quality photos?
Oh, they're talking about hiring a professional photographer to update your Tinder profile with the best pictures possible, because that's a thing. But you know it's a thing. I say that like I.
I mean, you have to catfish somebody somehow.
Yeah, that's true. Love that show, Catfish. By the way.
Very important, because we had, when he first started this process, we had like one guy. He was like, he is like average guy, but like he takes good care of himself. First time he got raped.
Wait, hold on. Was she just saying that he's an average guy?
Yeah, she's talking about one of their clients.
Oh, he was an average guy.
Yeah, but he also is, he's below average. If you had to rate his looks on a 1 to 10, I mean, I don't want to like, you know, I don't want to become that show, but I'm just asking you personally for your own personal opinion.
It's a pain level of 5.
That's a politically correct answer. For me, it's a pain level of 10 or a hot level of 1.
7.7.
It depends on if I'm just talking to him or if I'm actually having to date him or interact with him.
Well, you would never date him.
No, I would not.
No. I wouldn't let you date this guy.
No. He'd be the friend running after me in the club.
I'd be the cock blocker. Yeah. Wait. Don't isolate. Wait, don't isolate. Yeah. Okay.
I feel like this actually did happen to us a couple of times.
Of course it did.
Back in the day in the clubs.
Guys would cock block me all the time. They'd be like, that guy. Yeah. Here, we're going to go to get drinks and then go do something really fun without you. So, you know, she'll text you later. Wait, don't isolate. Don't go alone with your date. So I'm going to teach my kids. Yeah. Like stranger. Stranger danger. Yeah. Wait, don't isolate. Don't go home alone with the date.
Like now it's more than 1 year past. He's in another photo shoot and the guy is like 9. It's like, it's the same guy. But like from 7 to 9, because he got like all those specific details. Oh, do like that. Oh, you should like.
He went from a 7 to 9. First of all, how?
That's
subjective.
It's not.
What an objective scale you're using. He went from a 7 to 9.
To a 7.5.
Yeah, he went from a 7 to 7.1. And I'll spend $10,000.
A year later. 1 year later.
That's right.
He's gone from a 7 to a 9.
He flew us in to LA, put us up at the nicest hotels. We took some pictures with our portrait mode on our iPhone 7s.
Improve this part. And now, like, his pictures are just amazing.
Yeah.
Like, really, really, really cool.
Anyone that signs up for that 8-week program, we pair you, as I said, with a professional photographer in your city. And then Liz and the girls will go through the hundreds of photos.
What we do is we Google a photographer in your city.
That's right. What we do
is... We pair
is,
you. Yeah. Turn on your Bluetooth.
What we do is we use Groupon because no one else is using it.
I just saw a story about Groupon.
I know. Groupon is like, what? I never liked that idea in the first place.
The places I always went to without their crap, but anyways.
I know, whatever. We went to Groupon. We found a BOGO. What we did is we paired you with another one of our clients who lost money on our program, and you pay them. It's our way of paying back the customer. Hey, man, can't pay you back amount of money. Sorry about all your miserable experiences. Sorry about the fact you can't get laid. But if you can just take your iPhone and have a few photographs, we can give you $10,000 right now.
They'll pick the top 5, and that's what you're going to use on your online profile. But we have a 30-page guide that the girls put together that's going to give you exact directions on how to take your photos.
Oh, we got to get a hold of this 30-page guide.
The girls put together.
We've heard about your girls, John Anthony, first of all. Second of all,
30-page
guide. I want my hands on this guide.
Is this a text, Blake? Or is it
you've seen how this guy writes and reads. I mean... It's probably like hand drawn.
An 8-week program, 30-page guide. I mean, this is an intensive learning.
This is called adding value on top of value on top of value. Now all of a sudden, I feel like I'm like in an internet marketing pitch coach. Yeah. All of a sudden, I'm using ClickFunnels.
It's going to give you a whole bunch of example Tinder profiles, including my own, with full breakdowns of why it works so well. A lot of the most successful clients that have had the most success on Tinder, as well as my own, which is also really successful, all those will be broken down and you'll have a full blueprint. You can just hand it to the photographer. He'll know exactly how to take your pictures.
Oh, yeah. Nothing like showing up to the photographer with a 30-page blueprint on how to take my photograph.
And a couple of example Tinder profiles.
Yes.
Here, do this.
Here, you see John Anthony's Tinder profile? Do the opposite. If we showed up to our photographer with a 30-page guide, she'd laugh us out of the room. She'd be like, why are you hiring me? Just put your camera on a stick.
And that's going to showcase the best version of yourself. And I'm going to write your bio for you. So imagine, regardless of your skill level right now, you come on, you get the pro pictures, the girls pick the best five, we apply aesthetic upgrades on those, I write your bio for you. Now you're going to get a 90-
Oh, dude, if you're writing my bio for me, I might as well get my son to write my bio for me. Because I've seen some of the things you write.
I like electronic music.
Electric music is very nice in sunshine. Pluto is the 14th planet. Spelled P-L-A-N-N-E-T-T.
A difference in the quality and quantity.
Microphones.
I know he's got three microphones. Three lapel microphones.
He's got three. All right there together, too. Wait, boom his voice.
You know, here's
don't give her one, though.
No. She's loud enough. Mine will pick up you. First of all. Second of all. Thinking about it, this actually isn't a bad plan. We might want to think about this as a commercial break. It's to put three microphones. Probably save us some time.
Matches on Tinder, Bumble, and Hinge. Then when you get a match, you just plug into the plug-and-play messaging scripts that we provide, and that's going to turn those matches into phone numbers. Then you plug into the plug-and-play text scripts, and that's going to turn those phone numbers into dates. A bunch of those dates will be straight to the house, where all you need to do is hook up with the girl once she shows up. And the ones that are...
I had no idea. This whole time, I'm actually trying to talk to bitches.
It's simple.
All I had to do was...
Go through this whole step-by-step program, and then when she shows up at the house, just hook up.
That's right. Doorbell rings.
Boom.
Wait. Doorbell rings.
Threesome on the door.
Hey, bitch. We got your big fat fucking titties. I got my plug-and-play script here that says you're supposed to be sucking my dick right about now. I actually just put my dick through the mail drop and let him suck it from out there.
Just suck up.
Just gets me warmed up, you know what I'm saying? No talking. What happens when you don't have a script to run off of? You're writing all this shit, and then they show up to your house. You're like Cyrano de Bergerac or whatever that guy's name was. Who's that
guy? I think the plug-and-play script may be... calling somebody that you want to pay. Then when
how
she
much?
Shows up.
How much?
Here tonight. Yes.
Do you take American Express?
That's the script.
That's the script. Will my wife find the invoice?
Public for the coffee or drinks, I'm going to show you exactly how to run your public dates to bring home most of those girls and get the hookup afterwards. And I'm going to show you exactly how to keep around the ones that you want. So it's the full A to Z solution. It's a permanent and final solution.
Because you're going to have ones you don't want.
Yeah, this guy makes it sound like you're buying a used car. Drive around a few of them, the ones you don't want, just leave them on the side of the car. Leave them on the side of the road, throw the keys in there, call the dealership. Tell them. You got a stanker here. This car is stank. It's rank. However, I'll take the other two you gave me. Right. I'm fucking their tailpipes right now.
And as I said, we have over 1,000 testimonials on a page. It's indisputably the best program by far. There isn't even a
We got to listen to some of these testimonials.
No, it's the same. Look, that's the... that's him.
Yeah. That's him. You thought it was the same guy over and over. They're showing a screenshot of his website where he has all the testimonials. And each one of them has him in the test. By the way, Oh, I was about to say he's wearing the same shirt, and
he says it's the same picture. It's like a
let's
muscle,
just read one,
like a gold gym tank.
Let's just read one.
Yeah.
Chris was a man who already had success in dating, but wanted extra edge to get ahead and date even more women. What great sentence structure here. He says, absolutely transformative. Let's see things from a completely different level. This is the real deal. Now, he's on track to see dating women 3 or 4 times every week with ease. Who's writing this shit?
Val was trapped by the red pill for years, struggling to get results because of lack of practical advice. After working with John,
he was able to break through his mental barriers and get amazing results in his dating life. Now he will never struggle with self-doubt. Comma placement is everything, buddy. He will never struggle with self-doubt or dating ever again.
Check our proof page.
Proof page.
I mean, it's the proof.
Please, half the...
Proof's in the page. Yeah,
proof's in the page. And half the guys...
just write it, it's true.
That's right. And half the guys have their faces blurred.
I know. It's like a question page. Yeah,
it's so stupid. Proof page.
Program by far. There isn't even a close second. Very proud to have built that program. And we're really exploding this year. Okay, I just signed a 50...
You're very proud that guys all over the world are taking advantage of women based on your program, your blueprint? Yeah, asshole.
Podcast deal. I'm going to be appearing on a lot of podcasts around the internet.
He says he's going to be appearing on a lot of podcasts around the internet because that's where podcasts originate, on the internet. Hey, I just got off the phone with the internet and I'm going there soon. First of all, second of all, can you please come on our podcast?
Yes, that's what I'm thinking.
I would ask him all the tough questions.
Yep.
Yeah.
And we are very close to scaling paid advertising. Okay, so I really think our company is going to blow up. I know it's going to blow up.
Okay, so who fucking cares about your company? I mean, you're giving an update, a corporate update? I came here to learn how to get a threesome, and now you're giving me a shareholders meeting? Come on, man.
In the near future. All right, so prices will only continue to go up. And I highly encourage you guys to go check out one of those free calls right now.
If you want to skip all of the rejection and anxiety involved with getting girls and want me to personally help you instead, click the link and book a strategy call with me here.
Do you have anything else to add?
Wait,
before?
Wow, that was a commercial. What? He just put a commercial in the middle of his...
to say platinum selling technique. Hold on, go back.
By the way, platinum selling technique.
Look, and also, too, may I point out that he's using undercover cameras at a bar.
Yes.
Like, to go up a girl's skirt.
That's awful.
Look.
Yeah, it's awful. It's awful. He's got undercover cameras recording his every move.
Yeah.
And no one wants that.
Platinum dating system. We've got these vitamins, protein powder.
Protein powder, dick pills. Yeah, that's right.
$1,000 exclusively sold for Johnny F&M Lifestyle.
It's a fashion accelerator.
Oh, the fashion accelerator. That's another 30-page guide that's useless. By the way, for those of you shitting in the shower, you can use this to wipe your ass.
And book a strategy call with me here.
Do you have anything else to add before I go into the brief overview of the threesome blueprint?
The threesome was pretty cool.
Yeah. It's awesome because like
she just says the threesome was pretty cool.
Yeah.
That's all she keeps saying.
This threesome was pretty cool. I get paid extras for two.
The one that we had at the St. Patrick's Day.
St. Patrick's Day Carnival. Yeah. Asshole
girl, and we're just like, is she with this guy? Like, we didn't know the guy was gay or anything yet. We walk in, hey, I want to meet you, blah, blah, blah. How do you guys know each other? Oh, this is my friend, blah, blah. He's gay. Oh, cool, blah, 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 blah,
blah, blah, blah, blah.
This is my friend, he's gay. Who talks like that? This is my friend, he's gay. No, I'm not. You are tonight.
Blah, blah, blah.
Blah, 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 blah,
blah, blah. Start flirting, and they know, like, you didn't just come up to make small talk, right? The girl knows why you're there.
You wanna fuck.
But it helps when you have a pretty girl.
You want this tailpipe right in your engine. In the bathroom.
That guy's not just talking to me.
No. He wants to put a tailpipe in my engine in the bathroom in this crowded club during the middle of carnival. Nothing says respect like getting it in the ass in the middle of carnival in a dirty bathroom.
Ditching your friend.
In Brazil.
you, because that demonstrates pre-selection. I've already been pre-vetted, so to speak. So she's already tested to make sure I'm high value. She's already tested to make sure I'm not a creep, that I'm not a weirdo. So that eliminates...
What? No, she's in on your racket. That's what's going on. She's getting used to the John Anthony lifestyle. Which is you pay her to have sex with you, and she also
and
then
girls.
Lives in a penthouse apartment. Right. Yeah.
She's already vetted
That's
him.
That's right.
Thank God.
When I look at her and him, I go, well, can't be that
trustworthy.
Bad. Trustworthy. Yeah. She likes him. But then I hear her talking, and I'm like, well, who pre-vetted her?
Out of the safety objections, or the girl, you know, potentially worried about going home with you. Oh, is this guy a serial killer? Murderer? No, this girl's already vetted him for that. Is this guy like a loser? Is he kind of cool? Oh, he's cool. This girl that's pretty already approved of him, right? Yeah. So you bypass a lot of objections. You bypass a lot of this, like, you know, apprehensiveness or uneasiness
you
of the girl.
You go straight to fucking. Yeah. I mean, just slide right in.
Don't bother with all
Introduce
that.
Introduce everybody. It's already pre-vetted.
It's already pre-vetted.
Let's just hit the bathroom.
Don't worry about all the yip-yap.
Just wait this line for a little while.
Yeah.
And just a really quick overview. It's fully explained in the video on the end screen, but just a really quick overview is you'll go out with a bisexual girlfriend or a rotation girl. You will find a girl that you both like. You have the girl approach. You stay.
Are you a tire shop or what's going on? rotation girl.
As the guy, the girl approaches, usually opens with some kind of compliment. Oh, you're really pretty. I really like your dress. Oh, thank you. Blah, blah. Smile, right? And she has a good energy, like a welcoming warmth.
Remember to smile. Not like you're being kidnapped. She's proof. Proof of life. Remember to bring a newspaper with a current date on it so you could show your family.
Yeah, because, and also, too, let me just point out that their blueprint involves not only, this is not just for you, you've got to go find a girl that looks like
That's
Brazil,
right.
bring her in yes. on the racket, then to do the...
Yes, and Brazil, in my opinion, totally subjective, is a solid pain level 9. Yes. She's gorgeous.
Girls naturally are very receptive. And then from there, starts flirting a little bit. Oh, you're actually sexy, or you're really pretty, blah, blah, blah. Being a little physical, getting a little closer, flirting a little bit. A lot of times that will lead into a makeup. Then I will come in, and they're making...
Then I will come in and fuck them. Yes, while they're turned around so that they think you're a good lover. That's all in the John Anthony Platinum Plan. And we both get half a confirmed pull. That's how it works on the scorecard. 0.5 pull.
Yeah. Oh, hey, I'm with her. Me and my girl think you're really sexy. You're already in because she's approved of your girl. So you're taking turns alternating making out with the girls. You're triple kissing with the girls. And then from that point, it's just logistics. You're just going to say, oh, we live close.
It's just about managing to get your dick in their vagina when they have no interest in you.
You're a triple makeout.
Triple kissing. Triple kissing, please.
Okay, and we have various reasons that we can try to pull back with. Let's go have drinks there. Oh, no, I prefer to stay here. Oh, check out these three cute little dogs that we have. Do you like dogs? Oh, yeah. Do you want to meet them in person? Let's all go.
You want to pet my pussy?
You want to go get a drink? No, I'd prefer to stay here. Look at these three
little
dogs.
Look at these three little dogs. Aren't they cute?
You want to come meet
them? Yeah. Smell one. I put chloroform on their heads. Oh. I mean, I'm not joking about date rape. No. Please don't misunderstand me. I mean, I kind of am, but I'm not saying that it's funny. What I'm saying is this guy.
If I've ever seen,
in all the time that we have encountered so many creeps, the Frankie Bees and the fucking Mysteries and the other people, this is the cream of the crop creep.
He is the
and
cream of the crop
how
creep.
How anybody doesn't see through his bullshit is amazing to me. Of course, they don't have the benefit of watching one of his videos before he attacks them in a club.
Hang out there. Check out this view that we have. Let's all go hang out on the view. Oh, check out this jacuzzi that we have. We can say, let's all go on the jacuzzi. Let's go see the view. Let's go hang out with our dogs. Let's go have drinks there. Or let's do all those combined, right? And the girl feels comfortable and feels safe.
Yeah.
Well, let's go back to my place alone.
You don't want to have a drink? What if I offer you a drink, puppies, a hot tub, triple kissing,
a view,
and a Starbucks gift card for $5? What a deal. It's a platinum offer to suck my dick.
Another attractive female has already approved of you. So when you know how to do it properly, it can even be easier to pull a girl when you have a hot girl with you than it would be to pull a girl solo. Okay, because normally when the girl gives objections, it's coming from a place of, is this guy a weirdo?
I'm pretty sure Brazil is doing Morris code with her blinking. Help, get me out of here.
Is this guy a creep? Can I trust this guy? What if I go home and I don't want to hook up with this guy? Is he going to get angry? Is he going to be weird? How do I know this guy is actually the guy he says he is? Like, is he high value? Or how do I know, you know, his social status and this and that? A pretty girl already, like, eliminates all those things for them.
Oh, yeah, allows... yeah, dude, but you got to understand the guys who are...
Yeah, pretty girl just eliminates any kind of objection.
That's right.
That's, I mean, this guy's high value.
Listen, I
not a creep.
I've been friends with pretty girls all my life. It does not help me pull tail. Just sharing that with you. At all. It can be a benefit. I get it. I understand what he's saying.
It can kind of maybe be a little bit of a soft opening.
Sure.
But you've got to do the rest.
Yeah, you got to do the rest. You got to do the hard work of actually getting to know somebody and taking interests in them. And, you know, unless you're just John Anthony, first of all. Second of all, can we just point out, just for a second, I just want to share this with you, is that John Anthony is telling you that it's as simple as finding a best friend that's a solid 10 and then convincing her to help you get laid by other people. The guys who are going to buy your course, John Anthony, are not the kind of guys that are friends with 10s. Because I'm not even friends with 10s except for Krissy and my wife. Okay? That's a hard thing to come by. You might have a 10 in your orbit once a lifetime. And to convince her to tag along so that you could basically hoodwink women into sleeping with you.
She has to be a 10 bisexual.
Oh, a 10 bisexual.
Yeah, so that's even rarer.
A 10 bisexual that wants to have sex with me? It's like a unicorn.
And other girls.
I might as well find a leprechaun with a pot of gold. And not on a cereal box. You know what I'm talking about?
This short-circuiting, so to speak, okay? But check out that video on the end screen that will give a full explanation. If you want to learn my full system, check out the free call with a link in the description. And for this week only, we are also offering a funding option. Normally, you would have had to pay $5,000 or more upfront to be part of my 8-week program, but...
$5,000?
It's less than Frankie B.
That's true. Well, at least he's giving you a building to go, where you can bring your dates. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
At least you could live in it if you needed to. Fucking asshole.
With this new funding option, you can have payments for as little as $250 a month. You just have to be making over $35.
You can get on a payment plan.
In Brazil, that's an entire year's salary in some places.
A firm? Do you take a firm?
Yeah. Well, that's probably what he's doing is a firm. Shame on a firm or whatever. Shitty payment ass system. Plan. Yeah, payment plan. This better not be PayPal. That's all I got to say.
$1,000 a year and have over a 620 credit score. Feel free to sign up for one of those.
To have over a 620 credit score?
Your credit report, too.
You're going to pull my credit report? So I can pull tail? Oh, my God. This is such a fucking scam.
Calls, and you can go over the details of how that funding option works.
We won't use any of your personal information down here in Brazil.
Don't worry about
it. Just give me your social security. Yeah. That's it. I'm just running a credit report.
No problem.
Trust me. I've got this girl. She trusts me.
Yeah, she trusts me. You should trust me. Ignore those apartment applications coming from Rio de Janeiro. Just trying to look for a place for you to send your polls. You know what I'm talking about? I'm doing the work. Doing the work.
Pre-qualified to fit into that. Okay, and there's no money up front with that offer as well. So they'll go over all the details of that with you on the call. And
oh, great. I want you to get on the call so you can sell me a timeshare for pussy.
We will play some footage that we took from recording that night, and you guys can see us in action.
They had to blank the girl's face out because she probably didn't agree to be on camera.
She was like, I don't
want
to.
Thank you so much.
No.
Make sure you
that was it.
Oh, that was it?
And let us know what you think in the comments.
You showed
kissing
one
at the
kiss
club.
And that's it? Well, that was anticlimactic. I would have rather seen the bathroom fucking, but maybe that's another video. I'll do a little digging. Oh my God, this guy is an endless cauldron of cess. And you know what?
Shower shit.
Shame. Yeah, shower shit. That guy takes a shit in the shower. Guaranteed. Guaranteed. He takes a shit in the shower while she's in there with him. Guaranteed. Guaranteed. And he makes it sound pleasant to her. Oh my God. Guys, call me for a free 30-minute call on dating. I'll probably get you closer to getting laid than he will. Yes. Oh, man, do we have fun on the show. Well, hey, I want to thank everybody who's been leaving us wonderful reviews on Apple and CastBox and Podbean and all the other different places. Thank you so much. And thank you to all those who are writing in on the website, writing in on the text messages. We do love you. And it is one way that you can help the show. You can go to Apple and review the show, if you would, please, if you have Apple. Please review the show. Give us a few stars, whatever you like. It helps us get the word out there, stay on top of the charts, all that good
this
stuff.
This is what Brazil was doing.
Yeah. Solid 9 on the pain scale for you to go give it. Go give us an Apple review that says solid 5 on the Apple scale. And I also wanted to let you know that tcbpodcast.com is where you go. You can find out more information about Krissy and I. Read all the show notes, all the audio, all the video right there, every episode right there for you to watch or to listen to. And we're available wherever you're listening to podcasts right now. I don't know why I said that, because you're already listening to the podcast. So why
they know
I
where to go.
That? Yeah, you know where to go. You already know where to go. Mm-hmm. And if you want your free 21 EPM sticker, all you have to do is hit the Contact Us button on the website, send us your physical address, and we will send you that sticker along with a special treat, special prizes for those who let us know this month, in the month of April, that you would like that sticker. We're giving you some extras. So do that quickly. Go to the homepage, or go to the Contact Us page at tcbpodcast.com. 1-855-TCB-8383. 1-855-TCB-8383. Toll free from anywhere in the world. Text us comments, questions, concerns, content ideas. YouTube.com/thecommercialbreak. Fully edited episodes the same day they air here on the audio feed. Okay, Krissy. Oh, at the commercial break on YouTube. I love you.
I love you.
Best to you. Best to you. And best to you out there in the podcast universe. Until next time, Krissy and I always say, we do say, and we must say.
Goodbye.
How's your money feeling? It's about to feel happier with a certificate from Happy Money's partner, Michigan State University Federal Credit Union. Elevate and increase your savings with 18-month terms and only a $500 minimum. And the happiest part? MSU FCU certificates yield 4.5% APY annual percentage yield. Now that's a happier side of money. Elevate your savings. Go to happymoney.com/MSUFCU. That's MSU FCU. Funds insured up to $250,000 by NCUA. The APY is accurate as of the 12/1/2023 dividend declaration date. Early withdrawal penalties do apply. Fees may reduce earnings on the account. Any monthly withdrawals or transfers reduce earnings. How's your money feeling? It's about to feel happier with a certificate from Happy Money's partner, Michigan State University Federal Credit Union. Elevate and increase your savings with 18-month terms and only a $500 minimum. And the happiest part? MSU FCU certificates yield 4.5% APY annual percentage yield. Now that's a happier side of money. Elevate your savings. Go to happymoney.com/MSUFCU. That's MSUFCU. Funds insured up to $250,000 by NCUA. The APY is accurate as of the 12/1/2023 dividend declaration date. Early withdrawal penalties do apply. Fees may reduce earnings on the account. Any monthly withdrawals or transfers reduce earnings. Not all bread is created equal. And if you like yours soft, fluffy, moist, and delicious, then Hero Bread and Buns should be your first choice. But Hero Bread isn't just about taste and texture. It's high in fiber with ultra-low net carbs with 0 grams of sugar. Order today at hero.co and use the code AH10 to get 10% off your first purchase. That's AH10 at hero.co, H-E-R-O.co, for 10% off your first purchase.